In this video, I made 1000 AI zombies fight against a small bunch of well-trained AI soldiers. After training them for more than 50 hours, despite the numeric disadvantage, the soldiers were able to come up with some impressive comeback strategies. Make sure to watch this video till the end so you don't miss the mayhem that ensued in this fifth episode of Epic AI Wars. Just like the previous episodes, we will have two rivaling teams fight against each other. However, this time, the dispute is against the human faction and the undead. The human army will consist of musketeers as well as warriors, which you saw in the previous episodes. However, the undead have a completely new unit type. Meet the zombie. Similar to any other soldier types, a zombie can move in any direction, such as forward, backwards, left, right, and horizontally. They can also rotate their body left and right, mainly to scan the area. They do so by shooting a set of raycasts in different directions, which on collision will return the necessary information about the object, such as its tag and distance. So technically the agent's eyes, but that is basically where the similarities end. Zombies have incredibly slow move speed and only one hit point, which means they can be easily unalived. Well, technically they're already dead, so is it an unalived? Quite a philosophical question. Anyways, despite being so weak, zombies have one special trait. They can infect humans. If a zombie comes next to a soldier and bites him, not only the soldier will immediately join the Sudoku gang, but he will also be converted to a zombie. Not only humanity loses an ally, they gain a foe, just like Frodo when he put his finger in the wrong ring. I was also considering making some fast zombies, like the ones from Left 4 Dead or Dying Light, but the humanity would definitely stand no chance. This could still make for a fun short video, so let me know in the comments if you'd like to see the fast zombie apocalypse happen. I had 100 agents train in parallel, 50 in each team. Initially, they all were spawning in the mosh pit. That ensured that the agents are spawned in a random circle, where they were in a close proximity to their enemies, having a higher chance of hitting them while randomly spamming buttons trying to learn the rules of this environment. At start, all of them were confused and scattered across the map, similar to cockroaches in the kitchen when you turn on the light. Some zombies got shot at the beginning, but the rest of them just committed Sudoku by running into the wall, giving the first win to Team Humans. Yay! Next few rounds weren't any different, the agents trying to figure out and learn what the heck they are supposed to do. However, around iteration 7, zombies understood that smashing themselves into walls probably isn't the perfect strategy and started spending noticeably more time in the center of the map. This resulted in considerably less losses. This happened for another 20 or so rounds, until finally zombies have managed to catch and eat every single human and secured the first victory. Tasting human flesh proved beneficial for zombies learning, since following that, they easily scored multiple W's against the humanity. You see, sometimes all you need for motivation is a little taste of success. Or human flesh. Quite the philosophical episode this is. We are 50 training rounds in, and it seems that both teams understood the basics of the simulation, so time to make the two teams spawn apart. This is definitely a breath of fresh air for the entire human population, since now musketeers can use their main advantage, range, while warriors, well, yeah, I'm not sure what my plan was when adding warriors, since they're melee units, so quite an easy prey for the zombie. Well, sucks to suck. But we will try musketeer-only army against zombies right after this, so watch this video till the end. I let the agents train for several more hours, improving iteration by iteration, and after about 20 hours of training, here is the final result. 500 zombies will be fighting 500 musketeers and warriors, but before that, pause this video right now and let me know in the comments below, who you think will win, humanity or the zombies? Chaos started immediately. I'm not sure if the soldiers were so scared by the zombie threat, or I just didn't train them long enough and they were just that dumb, but humans started dropping each other left and right. Zombies are now winning without infecting a single human. Despite that, the brave-hearted warriors are rushing forwards towards the zombie horde. Unfortunately, bravery is not enough, since all of them had the worst faith imaginable. Despite their iron hearts, these men will not go to Valhalla with honor. Quite the opposite. Their unalived bodies will now fight against those who they called brothers. Well, perhaps I'm being overdramatic, considering how easily the musketeers were stabbing their teammates in the back, or I should say shooting. That being said, I think the ally slaughter actually makes sense. I know, that sounds weird, but hear me out. This is a zombie apocalypse we're talking about. Not just your regular day-to-day war with the neighboring faction. Oh no no. Here, each infected ally means one more opponent for their team. This means that each soldier that was infected without slaying a single zombie was not just useless, but actually detrimental. So, if in theory you would take out the weakest link in your army before they get a chance to be infected, you will have an overall smaller amount of zombies to deal with. Damn, that's cruel. Meanwhile, the humanity is down to less than 50 soldiers, while the zombie army is slowly advancing. Oh my god, just look at this dude rushing right into his... Yep. Anyways, the remaining soldiers seem to be doing a good job at keeping their ground, holding their line formation, and not allowing the zombies to advance. But just look at that! Zombies have switched their strategies, and instead of going into a bulk, they switched into a line formation, reducing the chances of being shot. This proves to be really efficient at penetrating enemy defense lines. Soldiers are trying to retreat while pushing the zombies, and it seems to be working. Zombie numbers are dropping extremely fast! I'm not sure what kind of dance party is that, but I wasn't invited, so I'm upset. The last attacking zombies were taken down and nothing happens. The soldiers were holding their positions, but the remaining zombies were not advancing anymore, so it kinda went like this forever. Which means it's a tie. But wait, that's not it. Remember, I said we gotta try musketeers versus zombies only, so I did just that. I went back to training, this time 100 zombies against 50 musketeers, since I wanted to have a much larger zombie army this time. And after about 40 hours of training, here is the final standoff. This time, 1000 zombies against 500 musketeers, and right off the bat we can see an improved strategy from our fellow humans. First of all, there is much less friendly fire going on, lame, I know, but also you can see the soldiers slowly advancing forward and forming into a defensive line formation, quite similar to the one we saw at the end of previous fight, however this time more efficient and brave, being right in the middle of the map. That being said, the zombies are already breaching their defenses. Despite slaying more than 100 zombies already, humanity still has more than 800 to go, and now they will also start infecting soldiers, increasing their army size. It seems like some sort of circle formation was attempted, but it was not too effective. The zombies have now successfully destroyed the line formation and are now overwhelming the rest of the survivors. We can see how the musketeers are attempting to keep distance. When the big blob of zombies is going in one direction, the formation is trying to move in the opposite direction. However, that works just until it doesn't. The zombie wave is reaching and engulfing the soldiers one by one, with each infected pulverizing humanity's chance for survival until... finally, the very last human is gone. By the way, the fun thing I noticed while editing is this row of unalived musketeers in the middle, which means that they were spanked by their teammates and not the zombies, you know, because they didn't convert. Well, there have been several suggestions to make this into a game where you can play as one of the soldier types and fight against the AI. If you think this is a good idea and something you want to see, let me know in the comments below, and I might just do that in one of the future videos. Also, what do you want to see next in the Epic AI War series? So far, the main candidates are Cavalry unit type, which will be a very quick melee unit, but with lower damage than the Warrior. The Engineer, soldier type, who will specialize in building barricades. A barricade will add the chance of dodging attacks for soldiers in close proximity. The Leader. And this is my personal favorite. Leaders will be a special unit type that will buff all nearby allies, however, if unalived, the entire team loses. This should add a whole new layer of strategy and complexity, since now soldiers who are losing might come back by slaying the opponent leader, and also soldiers will be motivated to protect their own leader. Do not confuse the leader with the commander, though. The commander will give orders and assign formations, but they haven't thought of a way of efficiently implementing him yet, since there are so many units. In the meantime, consider watching the fourth episode of Epic AI Wars, where I introduced the medics and perhaps made them slightly OP. Bye!